Hi guys, so in today's video I'm going to be doing a video walkthrough on how I do dog noses. I'll be using water soluble colour pencils as always, and this is just to show you the process that I go through to create them in real time. So first thing is I'm going to pick out all the colours I'm going to be using. I have a colour chart as well, so I can see what all the colours look like when they've been activated with water. So this is a liver dog, so all of the colours will be really nice, kind of rosy, browns, that kind of thing. So I'm just going to pick out the ones that I think will suit best. So I have also picked out a couple of supracolor pencils. I can't remember what this one's called. Oh, granite rose. And, oh, I'm not sure what this one's called either. Brownish orange, I think, number 45 in the supracolor. These are very much my go-to pencils when doing this coloured nose. I think they're really nice and soft colours, and yeah, they just really go with that browny leather colour. And now I'll pick out my museum ones. Okay, so these are just a couple of the colours that I picked out. These are, and I'll kind of go through them all by name when I come to using them. But this is the colour palette that I'm going for, and I'll probably pick out a couple more as I go through the process, because yeah, it changes as you go, like how you feel things are going. So yeah, let's get started. So now I'm just going to be creating a very kind of rough base. So my pencils aren't very sharp for this because they don't need to be. It's just a very blunt base colour, and I'm just going over it very softly, covering the entire area with colour. And this is brown. And I'm going to go over it with the brownish orange. So you can barely even see what I'm doing in the camera, but there is colour going down, but that's how lightly I'm doing it. Because when you activate water soluble colour pencils, they do become really pigmented. So I don't like to go down too heavy at the start, I like to go down quite nice and soft, and then build up on those areas if I need to. And this is anthraquinoid pink, I'm not sure if that's how you say it right. Now these liver dog noses are very nice and pinky, so I'm just adding lots of pink tones in there. This time I'm not covering the whole area as much, just focusing on the more pinky areas. I've just picked up the chestnut colour from my palette because I thought this would be a nice colour to go on the outside. Now, as you can see, like, my line art is kind of fading away, but that's okay because I can still see where I'm going, and I will leave the nostrils clear. I won't paint those initially, just so I can still see where the nostrils should go. That'll make more sense, like, when you see it wet, because, yeah, it's a lot harder to see anatomy when you paint all of it and it all goes wet. Oh, I forgot to say, I probably will cut out some parts, because, like, things like waiting for it to dry aren't very exciting, so I'll try and cut those bits out, but for the most part, it'll be all real time, no speeding up. But yeah, things like waiting for it to dry, sharpening pencils, I'll probably cut out, because that's not helpful. It is important to wait for the pencil to dry though, I find, at least, because otherwise it kind of goes on, it just goes on very blotchy. The colour doesn't attach as quite as nicely as if you wait for it to dry, so I do like to wait for it to dry. That's just a personal preference, but it does mean that the pencils last longer, they don't go on quite as chunky. Yeah, so that's why I like to wait for it to dry. So as you can see, you can't really tell how it's going to turn out at the moment, because there's no real colours popping out at you. So I'm going to wet it, see how everything looks, how everything activates, and then if needs be, add another layer of colour. I don't like to do any detail in this stage, because once you wet these pencils, it kind of all blends together, so any detail that you do gets lost. And there's no point in continually adding detail and then losing it and then adding it again. But that's just how I like to do it. As you can see, it is starting to layer up a bit more. You can actually see colours going down a bit better now. But again, this isn't anything like what it'll look once it's been activated. And just a bit of French grey. This is quite a nice browny grey colour. It's very lighty. In the middle of the nose here. Okay, and now I'll wet everything down. See, now I'm going to blend it all together with water. And I do this with plain water, a nice watercolour brush. This is also by Rowney. And I just dampen it off a little bit, so make sure it's not dripping wet, because otherwise I find it tends to push colour more than blend it. So just dampen it off a bit and blend. Now you can see all of the colours are starting to activate. I find it works better if you go blend the lighter colour first and then do the darker ones, because otherwise the darker ones tend to blend into the lighter ones and it gets a bit muddy and all one colour, whereas if you start with the light ones, then you can blend those into the dark ones a bit better. And every time I want it to blend a little bit softer and spread a little bit, not as far, I take off a bit more water from my paintbrush so it gets drier. So the drier the brush, the less the paint will spread, or less the colour will spread. But obviously if we do it too dry, then it won't spread at all. And it's okay if it's ever a bit patchy, because this is just the first base and you're really not going to see how patchy it is when you get to the end. And again, I'm just leaving the nostrils clear so I can darken those up at the end and I can still see the anatomy of the dog's nose a bit better. And again, I'm just drying the brush. The less I want it to spread, so then the colour won't spread as far. There you go. And again, it's okay if it's a bit patchy and are there any harsh lines, because you won't see them at the end. To be honest, these aren't super harsh. I think supracolours kind of blend a lot harsher. There's more harsh lines when I use those than these museum pencils. But no matter what watercolour pencil you brand, if there's any harsh lines, don't worry about it. Okay, and now, unfortunately, I have to wait for it to dry. So, I'll wait for it to dry and then carry on. Okay, so now it's all nice and dry, I'm just going to go in and kind of, what's the word, add to the tonal values, so make things a bit darker in areas. I'm going to go over and make some areas a bit pinker, but yeah, the most important part now is adding to the tonal values, making your darks dark, and yeah, the lights are still light, so just making everything a bit darker really. And this will be another wet layer that will be blended, and then we can do dry details over the top. So it is quite a lot of layers, so it's important to make sure you have nice watercolour paper that can take it. These pencils are fabulous because they do layer really well on top of each other. I'm not focusing on any details, so not focusing on the texture of the dog's nose, just the shape, the anatomy and the tonal values. Making sure all of the colours are down and I'm really happy with them. And now we're using burnt sienna to just darken up these pinky areas a bit more. Now you don't want to do this completely random, you do want to focus on the shape of the nose just a little bit. When you're getting colour down, you should try and build on the shape of the anatomy rather than just placing it down. But it is just the early stage, so it doesn't matter if it's not perfect, you can build on it later. Okay, so now to darken up some of the areas, I'm using terracotta, brown, and russet. And these will make some areas a bit more orangey, some areas a bit more brown. I'm just building on the colours while also adding to the tonal values. Now again, these colours are a lot more pigmented wet than they are dry, so I don't like to go too harsh too soon. I'm applying very little pressure, if any at all really, just gliding the pencil along. Okay, and this is terracotta, and I do keep looking at my colour chart as well, just making sure they are the right ones, because obviously they activate differently than how they look on the pencil and how they look on the paper. And lastly, I'm going in with brown. Okay, I think I'm gonna get some more greys. Here we go. Alright, I'm gonna get grey, French grey, and Castle Earth to just darken up this middle part of the dog's nose. When I'm painting, I don't usually have a plan on like what colours to pick, or like I don't write down a cheat sheet for what colours to use for a liver dog's nose. I just go off what I think would look best for each individual dog. And that's just from lots of practice, I guess, building up your eye for different colours. Yeah, unfortunately there's no cheat for that really. If you are struggling, you can use things like the colour picker tool on Photoshop. Hold your colour palette up against your reference photo, but I just like to go off eye most of the time. But there's no right or wrong, just do whatever you're comfortable with. Okay, I'm just getting a bit more brown and darkening up this area. So as you can see, dog's noses are round, so we can like kind of curve some certain edges as you're shading, and that'll give you the shape that you're looking for. The more you can do like in these early stages, the easier it will be later, I always find. Okay, and I'm actually gonna go and grab a purple. I think I'm going to go with periwinkle purple. Or periwinkle blue, sorry. Just getting a bit of periwinkle blue and adding it to this corner here. I always find the colours like purple add a nice rich depth to colours like brown, chestnut. It just adds, yeah, a nice soft rich depth. I'm just going to brush off any excess colour that might have gone onto the paper because we don't want that spreading or blending around. Right, and again, just dampening my brush, ready to blend all of these colours. Okay, there we go. So again, it might look a bit odd, but that's okay. It's only a very early stage. Okay, so it's starting to build up though. You're getting more tonal values, you're getting the right colours. Oh, I'm dropping this one. Okay, so yeah, the colours are starting to build up, the tonal values are starting to build up. I will do one more. Oh, I will do one more layer wet, and then everything else will be dry on top. So yeah, it is quite a slow, long process, but this is just the way I like to work, especially with dog noses. Okie doke. And again, I'm just picking my colours for this next part. I'm gonna grab another purple and maybe another ready colour. You can never have too many colours. Okay. Okay, so while the nose area dries, I'm going to do the nostrils. And these are the colours that I'm using for the nostrils. It's quite a lot. We have crimson aubergine, dark plum, violet, carmine lake, I'm sorry if I butcher these names, and brown and raw umber. Well, this is a lot of colours, but I do like to use a lot to add depth. I find the more different colours you use, instead of like just plain black, it adds a lot more depth. And I probably will use a black to darken it up at the end, but first, I'm just going to see what these look like. And it might sound odd, but I do find that doing it this way, it does make the black blacker. I'm not sure why, but yeah, that's just what I find. I'm not really doing these in any specific order. I'm just putting them down as I go. And I'll use some of these same colours to darken up other areas like around here. But for now, we'll just wait for that bit to dry and I'll do the nostrils. There you go, so you can see it doesn't look very dark. I'm not going to leave it like that. I am going to go over and add a black. Yeah, I'm going to go over and add a black after I darken up these areas. So just using a brown. And this is when we add our final wet layer. Just really making sure we add that shape, get those tonal values down. I'm gonna get a bit of the grey because this area is a bit more grey. This in the middle. I'm gonna add a tiny bit of purple right in the center. very lightly. I'm not even sure if the camera is picking up any of that purple colour, but it's there. See, and now you can see it really starting to take shape even more, just really darkening up different areas. Okay, I'm going to use Carmine Lake. This is a really nice kind of browny, slightly purple colour, but it's a really nice dark brown. One of my favourite colours from this set, I've used it so much. Might leave this dry instead of wetting it because they have blended quite nicely. I'm not sure if it needs to be blended with water, so I might actually just leave this dry. We'll see. See, I told you I don't really have a plan when I'm painting. I just kind of go by eye and how it looks in the moment. Not every process is always the same. Okay, so I'm just going to blend the grey on the right side and the grey in the middle. Okay. Add a couple more bits of colour. I think I'm going to get another purple as well. Oh, I'm definitely not going to be able to say the name of this one. This is my manganese violet. Lovely. I'm just like going over some of the pink areas of this. Okay, and I'm gonna just darken up the middle of the nose again, and then this time I'm going to use a black. I'm gonna use ivory black. So the museum colour pencils have two different blacks, and I found one of them is more of a cool tone black, and one of them is more of a warm tone black, which might sound weird. But I like to use a warmer black first, especially with these pet portraits. It's definitely my preference. Okay, now I'm going in with the black. And just very lightly darkening up this nostril. There you go. Now if you compare the two, this one's definitely a lot darker, but it's a really nice and rich in colour despite it being super dark. Right, so now I'm just going to do any kind of finishing touches just on the colour, just on the tonal values on this nose, and then I can go in and detail them afterwards. So right now I'm not very happy with this part of the nose, or this part. I think they could be a bit more colourful, a bit more shaped, if that's the right word. So I'm going to go in and do that, and I might do these parts of the nose as well. Now the reason I'm doing this is I find it a lot harder to adjust it once you go into detailing the nose. So if I can do this before I do that, then it'll be so much easier. Okay, I'm just gonna add a couple more colours to this nose, just because I'm not completely happy with it right now. That's okay. Like I said at the beginning, I do like my noses to be quite pinky, so I just gotta make it a little bit more pinky in places. Okay. Now before I lighten up this nose, I'm gonna darken it. So get this nice black ivory black, and in the more shadowy areas of the nose, I'm just going to go over these little bumps. So this is adding a nice bit of depth. See, already it's like bringing out these little areas. So we're going to do the same over this side. And I'm not doing this completely random, I am paying attention to the reference photo and where the nose seems to be darker. And we'll just darken the outside as well. Inside, and then here on the left side of the nose, because the light is kind of coming like this way, so it's really hitting some of the creases on this side of the nose. And then again on this side. Now some creases are darker than others. I think it's just where that part of the nose is slightly deeper. It's quite kind of random, but very individual to the duck's nose. Okay, so now those are quite considerably dark. I'm just gonna blend these together as well while I've got my black pencil out. Okay. Now to lighten up this area of the nose, like here, I'm going to use my Derwent electric eraser. And you can see already it's kind of pulling up bits of the little texture of the nose that I've put down, so it's already very light. A lot lighter even than these parts here. So just going to continue to do that across the nose. So basically just after the light there will be a shadow, and just after the shadow there will be a light, because that's just how light works, I guess. So it's important to lighten up any areas that you darken and vice versa. I'm just going to add a little bit more texture down here. There we go. Maybe here as well. Another side. Now what also sometimes happens is these little circles have like kind of little dots in them. I'm really sorry, I'm not sure what the technical term is or why, but this is just something I've observed. They kind of have like very high points, so if you add little circles it kind of creates a slight high point in the highlight. I'm only doing this across a couple, don't have to do it across every single one. This is a lot easier if you're working on a larger piece as well. So if you're working on a larger piece, I definitely recommend adding these little tiny circle parts. Okay, and now I'm just going to add a little bit of colour, kind of in bits that I feel like need it, and then I think we're almost done. And this kind of blends the leather circles together as well a bit better, and softens them up. Because it can look quite harsh otherwise, but once you do this they do blend a little bit nicer. And I'm gonna get nice. I'm gonna get this brown, which is quite nice and ready brown, and then just blend this bit in as well. There we go. So now you might notice it's very dark, it's all shaded, there's no highlights. So I'm gonna grab a white museum pencil. This is my favourite white pencil ever. It's just so nice. So even if you don't use this brand, I do recommend buying this pencil. I'm gonna sharpen it. So now it's nice and sharp, and I'm just gonna start adding in all the little highlights on this duck's nose. And again, it's really important to pay attention to your reference photo. Wherever there's a dark crease, there's usually a nice bright highlight right after it. But make sure you pay attention to your reference photo. Okay, and I'm gonna get this pink and just kind of colour this in so it's not quite as bright white in some areas. And then again, just after that crease, add in a nice little highlight in there. So dog's noses are supposed to be very wet, so it's really important that you get this nice bright highlight because this will make the wet nose effect. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is get my nice pink colour and just go all over the top of it. And again, that'll blend in the top but also create a nice pink highlight. Very subtle, but it adds to it. Oh. So I'm just going to very lightly, I'm going to finish doing this part, and then I'm going to very lightly go over it all with the white pencil. Super, super light. And I'm going to get this light cobalt blue and just add a couple blue highlights over on this side. Okay, and now I've got most of it done, but if I can find a good pencil. So this is a really old white museum pencil. I don't even know if you can tell, but it's really old and I like to use this by just getting my little glass of water, dipping it in, blowing it so it's a bit dry, but you don't want it super wet, again just damp. Okay, and then when you've got kind of not super dripping wet but a little bit damp, just add a couple little dots, and you see how pigmented that is? That really makes it look like really bright white textured highlights. Okay, and then if it gets too dry, it won't work as well, so just add a bit of water. Same thing, dry it off a bit. Make sure it's not completely dripping wet. And then add your highlights. There we go. And then just kind of blend those together with your dry museum pencil. And I'm going to add a bit more pink around it. And just kind of blend all these areas together really nicely, get some nice pigment popping. And this is a really nice colour as well, the apricot. This was one of my favourites in the supracolor set as well. Just get a really nice kind of orangey colour there. And then if you pair it with the pink as well, it makes a really nice pinky orange. I'm just going to go over it with the pink. And then I'll finish it off with this brownish orange. So really just kind of going over the base with all the colours that we used before, but now you blend in the texture into it. Okay, so there we go. I think we're done with this video. I hope you liked it. I hope it helped. Please let me know if you enjoyed it, if you want to see more of this type of video. If you have any other video ideas you'd like to see, please let me know. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.